Dobrý den, mé jméno je Michal Brodil.
Hi, my name is Michal Brodil and we are standing here right in front of the Prague Planetarium. As you will see, we have plenty of amazing toys here that would have never existed without the help of 3D printing. So here we are next to the Lunar Module access hatch. However, before we enter, let's talk a bit about the thrusters. These are PLA prints. Of course, they deform a bit over time, but their longevity is definitely much better than we thought. When we decided to place the lunar module outside, we tried to anticipate the worst sources of wear and tear. Sun, frost, wind, or vandalism? Well, now we know, it's birds. Magpies are fascinated by the materials, especially the aluminum foil. They peck at the module all the time and use the bits and pieces to build their cosmic nests in the surrounding park. Welcome to the inside of the lunar module. Before I describe the cockpit a bit more, I have to say that, in a way, I have to doubt the mental health of the astronauts, who basically volunteered to be shot to the moon in a small metal box. Well, anyway, let's talk about the control panels. There is a relatively smaller amount of 3D printed parts on them compared to the Space Shuttle cockpit. When we built the module, we were still learning what is 3D printing capable of. Nevertheless, the technology helped us a lot even in this case. More printed parts were used later to build the onboard computer. By the way, this computer is the grandfather of modern computers. I think it's the single most important component, and in my humble opinion, its performance was the decisive factor in getting the crew to the moon and back safely. The fun fact is, already in these pioneering times, there was a simple troubleshooting recommendation. If you don't know what's wrong, try to turn it off and on again. There is a lot of switches, very popular with children. As soon as they enter, you can hear a non-stop high-frequency clicking sound. Switches made to last for a lifetime have about 2 weeks longevity here. And now let's go inside and take a look at the Atlantis Space Shuttle. These panels are printed as a sandwich of a transparent PLA layer and a white PLA layer. It is painted gray and the letters are then machine engraved into the paint. Everything is going to be semi-functional, with the switches connected to Arduinos and a controlling computer. The whole panels, the switch heads and the guards are all 3D printed. The basic construction is plastic and wood. This whole rack and the extension holders are 3D printed too. Let's go closer and look at the thruster vents. Everything here can be made with more old-fashioned modeling methods, but these shapes are so specific that 3D printing is basically the only viable option. Bending them from sheet metal or whatever would take months and probably end up with a barely passable result. So I think this part of the fuselage is where 3D printing played its most dominant role. The parts are not perfect, but they look correctly and blend well with the rest of the construction. 3D printing was also crucial for the cockpit window gaskets. At the moment, we have four original Prusa 3D printers here. We've been using them for several years, and actually our first model was an old Prusa printer, as far as I remember, without the MK number in its name, with a glass print bed. At the moment, we are printing the Space Shuttle astronaut helmets, which will be available for visitors. Do you realize this is basically like the replicator? For me, this is Star Trek, science fiction technology, and I would have never imagined this would be possible one day. This is a fuel tank for a space shuttle model of substantial size, and this is the space shuttle itself. I went a bit crazy with this one, scaling up the original model quite a bit, about twice the size. All the post-processing and assemblies start to be difficult, but it's still doable. Looks quite majestic, doesn't it?